In this video, we will mainly discuss about distance, displacement, speed and velocity. And at the end of the video, there are a few practice questions for your self-assessment. So let's get started. Distance and displacement are both quantities of length, but the major difference lies in how the length is measured. Distance is the length of the total path followed between initial and the final positions, whereas the displacement means the shortest path between the initial and the final positions. To explain this, consider an example of a boy who has to reach his home. And let's say he have taken a curved path. Then the distance is given by the total length along the curved path, and the displacement is a line joining the initial and the final positions. Displacement is a vector quantity, which means it has both magnitude and direction. Its direction is given from initial to the final positions, whereas distance is a scalar quantity, so it doesn't have any direction, but it has a magnitude. Now let's discuss about speed and velocity, which are derived quantities of distance and displacement with respect to the time. Speed is defined as the distance covered per unit time, whereas velocity is defined as displacement per unit time. And since distance is a scalar quantity, speed is also a scalar quantity, which means it doesn't have any direction. And velocity is a vector quantity which has a direction equal to that of displacement. To explain this further, let's consider a ball is thrown as a projectile. If the ball covers a distance s in 1 second, then its speed is equal to distance covered to that of the time duration. So it will be equal to distance covered, that is s divided by 1 second, which is s units. And its units is given by meter per second or kilometer per hour. Now let's consider a similar kind of case for the velocity. And in this case, let's assume that the ball has a displacement of s meters after 1 second. Then the magnitude of velocity is given by displacement by time, which is equals to s meter per second. And since its direction is making an angle of theta with the x-axis, direction vector is given by cos theta I cap plus sin theta j cap, where I cap and j cap are unit vectors of x and y axis. Now here comes the question for you. If a person has walked along the circle of radius r and reached the same initial position, then what is the displacement and distance covered by the person? So just pause the video and try. So the answer is, since the initial and final positions are equal, displacement will be equal to zero. The distance is equal to the perimeter of the circle, which is equal to 2 pi r. In the previous case, we have considered the velocity in a small duration of time, that is 1 second. But if you want the velocity at a particular instant of time, then we need to express the velocity as a differential form. So consider the motion of the ball between a very small duration of time, which is delta t. And in this time, the displacement is delta s. So the velocity is given by delta s by delta t. And the direction of velocity will be equal to that of delta s. Now if this time duration tends to 0, then the equation will be modified as v equal to ds by dt, which is a differential equation. This equation will give the magnitude of the velocity. But in order to find the direction of the velocity, let's consider the delta s is tending to 0. Then you can see that it is eventually becoming the tangent of the curve. So at any particular instant in a curved path, the velocity direction is given by the tangent at that point. Please post the answer or any suggestions you have in the comment box. And if you enjoy the video, please do like, share and subscribe.